What's up, guys? It's that time. What's happening? It's been ages. Absolutely ages. I haven't done a video in since God knows how long. What time is it now? Yeah, months ago. Absolutely months ago. But nevertheless, here I am. I'm doing it. I'm doing it. So today, I've got a juice review for you guys today. It's a triple juice review. It is the CNDI range, a henhouse range from Custom Vapes, London, E15, Plaistow. Oh yeah. So I've got the triple juice review of theirs today. Last time I tried it was at the Vapor Expo. I haven't tried it since. I've been that busy and doing, like, managing the shop that I'm the manager of now and sorting out birthdays and Christmas and poxy bloody snow days. It's absolutely freezing right now. If you can hear a little buzz in the background or a little, it's because my heat is literally right there on me. I'm in the log cabin. I'm actually freezing my tits off right now. It is that cold. My ears are cold. My nose is cold. Oh my God. This juice is cold. Don't know how it's gonna vape, but still, it's sort of warming up. So yes, we are going to take it down low, build cam, table cam, whatever you want to call it. I like to call it the build cam. So we're gonna take it down low to the build cam. I'm not building anything, but you know, it's gonna be the build cam. It is the build cam because that's what it was intentional use was for. Fucking hell, I can't get my words out. Because I'm a div. Right, anyway, so I'm going to take you down to the build cam. We're going to have a look at the bottles. Very borderline. Very, very borderline. But I'll get back to that in a little while. But yes. And we're going to hit this juice up. Like I say, I haven't. We're in December of like the first quarter of December now. And when was the expo? Ooh. Was when? November? October? Can't remember. Anyway, it's been well over a month, maybe two, but we'll see. Ooh, giving them a shake or. I thought it was leaking then. Ooh, it is. Ooh, cotton candy. So let's go down low. Let's do this. And then I will, show you what's what. Yes, I forgot the buttons, but I'm on it. Here we go. So this is the down low. So this is the packaging. This one to me is very, very borderline, but it's okay. It just about gets away with it in my eyes. Just because, obviously, of the name of it and what it's meant to be, they have got a little bit of a slogan on when the wherever it is on a website saying a certain little slogan. I will not be repeating that slogan, but I will be giving you the juice review. It is meant to be white chocolate. Obviously, we know what white chocolate it's meant to be, but it's very, very touch and go with the design and the packaging here. But there's nothing that, only apart from the colours, and if you know what I'm on about, you'll know what I mean. I don't really want to mention it like that because we're not going down that route. But it is borderline, but it does pass in my opinion this occasion. And that's the only one that I've really got a problem with. So that is the packaging. It's quite nice, quite jazzy packaging. It's like see-through, so you can actually see the liquid through these bits here. Yeah, it's got the brand on there. It tells you the flavor profile there. You've got all the manufacturer ingredients, manufacturer details, the barcode, and all that palaver there. You've got to be 18 plus to vape it, obviously, and it is recyclable, which is also a good thing. And it tells you that it is a 50 ml bottle, 0 mg, and it is made in the UK. This In fact, it's not a 50ml bottle, I lied. It's 50ml of juice in a 60ml bottle. So if you wanted to add your Nick Shot, it is a short fill. There is a space for the short fill Nick Shot to go in there. So yes, not bad. Next one, cotton candy, quite nice. I like how they've got the colour coordination going on with the actual of the labelling to go with the actual flavour profile that it's got. The juice has not had no colourings added to it, so it's very clean. It looks quite clean. Like, you know, so some people tend to think, oh, cotton candy, let's put a load of pink in there, let's, you know. But no, you don't need to do that. Keep it what it is. If the flavour is good enough, it will speak for itself. You don't need to add colours and all this stuff to make it stand out. The flavour should do that on its own. Like I say, packaging, really nice. I like this packaging. Well, should I say the labelling? The packaging is just a bottle, but the labelling is the branding. The branding is nice. I like it. Obviously, this is cotton candy and it's pink. And also, you know, with these bits here, it's not, you can actually see through, you can see the juice through there. Like, it's quite different. I haven't seen bottles like this before. Normally it's a sticker that's like caked on there, you can't see anything inside, or normally like a black bottle and then you can't see anything anyway. So yes. And then this one is the lemon bonbon one, same again. They've kept it consistent throughout the theming with like the see-through bits on here. This one's got blue bits that are see-through, the yellow's a solid colour. This is lemon bonbon, so your classic lemon bonbon sweet. And yeah, all the relevant information follows through on all three of these bottles, ingredients and warnings and where it's made and barcode and, you know, over 18 plus, like to vape it. Yes, we all know that, that's standard practice, but it's good that they're following what they need to follow to put it on there. And it's a good thing that they put on there that the bottle is actually recyclable. We should be recycling bottles. I actually recycle them, put different juice in them, but that's a different matter, I suppose. But you can actually take these to wherever they recycle plastic and have these recycled, which is a good thing for the environment. Anyway, same stuff on here, 50ml of juice, 0mg, made in the UK. Short fill bottle is a 60ml bottle, and you can put your Nick Shot in there to make it up to 3mg. So without further ado, I'm going to bring you back up top. There we go. And we are going to rip these up. I have got my mod, so today, obviously as every other day, it is nice and freshly wicked. I have got my Ali Mongrel with my stainless steel Apocalypse RDA with my flat wire flat build in there, running super low. As always, I'm not promoting the super low build, but I like it. I know what I'm doing with my build, that's cool. So we're gonna go look at the profile of the first one, and then I'm gonna hit it up and describe it and let you guys know what I think. So here we go. Stone Vapes, this is White Chocolate. White Chocolate is a nostalgic creamy white chocolate bar that will transport you right back to your childhood. Smooth, soft and creamy. There was another bit in there, like I said, I am not going to say that bit just because, no, I don't think I should do, but that's my opinion. There we go, that's what it is. So it's a nice creamy white chocolate bar that'll bring you right back to your childhood memories. It's a 50ml liquid in the 60ml bottle, 0mg, Nick Shot ready, and it's 70-30 PGVG. So without further ado, let's go back here, and I'm gonna get this, whoop, nearly, and I'm gonna crack the bottle open. So look, this is the first time I'm actually cracking bottles open. So, epoxy ring. Oh, let's give it a little bit of a lick test. Okay. Quite sweet. Not what I was expecting. I don't know why. But we'll see how this bad boy vapes. Right then. Here we go. Quite creamy. I've never really had white chocolate, I suppose. Maybe if I have, it's a long time ago. But I don't know if I'm getting the white chocolate from it. I'm getting a nice, smooth, creamy vape from it, though. Might have background notes of, like, a chocolate sort of vape. But, excuse me, I've got to do this. This is raw now. It's very cold. Anyway, let's get back to it. But I don't know, when I associate chocolate and vapes, I always think of like dark, powdery, cocoa-y chocolate. This is throwing me right off with a white chocolate. Yeah, I'm getting it. Ever so faint, but I've got more of rich, creamy, smooth, silkiness going on in there. It's different. It is a different vape. Vapor production's really good on this. Really good. Sweet. See, it is a bit of a difficult one for me because I don't, like, eat white chocolate as such. I can't remember the last time I've had it, so I can't really compare it to the last time I had a bit of chocolate. But like I said, it sort of threw me off a bit. When I'd done the lip test, it was nice and sweet and creamy. Mind you saying that, I've got a taste there now. But I'm not sure if I can relate to it as being white chocolate. But it's a nice creamy vape. Nice, smooth, silky. It's going to make me want to go out now, get a bit of white chocolate just to compare it to it. There was I had a different like taste that time. It was like quite, I don't know. It's really, really hard to say. I smelt it. I just smelt a big fat whiff of it then. I'm getting a nice, creamy, smooth, silky, like, creamy taste from it. It's difficult. It must be the white chocolate because it's not milk and it's not cream. You know, you have milky vapes out there and you have, like, cream vapes out there. It's not like that. It's totally on its own. It's quite nice. I've got to say, it is very nice. Maybe what I should have done before this, maybe I should have went and had a bit of white chocolate just so I could compare it to it. But you don't think of them things, do you? Vapor production on this is lovely, 70-30. Full, like, bodied with creaminess and silkiness and smoothiness. It's nice, I'm liking it. I could vape this all day, to be fair. See, I was kind of a bit on the fence about a chocolate vape. Because chocolate vapes, well, obviously this is different. This is a white chocolate vape. But when I think of chocolate vapes, I think of like, you know, milk chocolate, dark chocolate, and they taste very cocoa-y, very powdery. Well, this is just totally not even on that scale. This is right down on the creamy, like, I wouldn't say like in the custardy end of the scale, but near that sort of end rather than the chocolate end of the scale where it's like really cocoa-y and really powdery. You get that powdery, cocoa-y feel when you vape like a chocolate vape. But with this, like I say, it's going towards like the custardy, creamy end of things, but it's like it's got a unique flavour of its own, a unique taste. It's a very nice taste. It's just got about the right amount of sweetness in there. It's like texture is lovely. The creaminess is really good. I'm liking it. I could vape this on it every day. It has got something else there, but like I said, I can't compare it to like white chocolate because I don't. I'm lactose intolerant, so I tend to like stay away from the chocolatey side of things. Like I do like a bit of chocolate when I do have chocolate though, and I shouldn't really have it, but I don't normally go for like a white chocolate. But as a vape, this tastes amazing. I'm liking it. So yeah, maybe someone else out there can give me a bit of feedback in the comments. So you know, drop a comment in the box below and whatever. Let me know what you think of it. And you know, taste is very subjective. So yeah, overall, nice, sweet. I've got the taste there now of the creamy sweetness. It's really good. I'm liking it. So without further ado, we're gonna move on to the next one, and then we're gonna vape that up, and I'm gonna let you know. So here we go. Let's move on. Custom vapes, cotton candy. So cotton candy will take you to the fairground and give you that cloud of fluffiest cotton candy mixed with a splash of fresh strawberry milk. Sounds good. 50 milligram liquid in a 60 ml bottle, 0 mg nicotine, nick shot ready, and again 70/30 VGPG. Nice. So let's take it back up to the top. Freshly whipped, ready to roll. Here we go. Oh my gosh. That smells really sweet. I can taste strawberry in that. You can actually taste the strawberry milkshakey type feeling going on there. So flipping freezing down there, you don't understand. So here we go, let's hit this one up, shall we? Wow. In all honesty, I'm not feeling much of the like the cotton candy vibe from it. I know because I made loads of it for my wedding. Like I made fucking 200-300 bags of it. I'm not feeling like as if it's like I'm eating cotton candy, but I'm getting a nice sweet taste, and then I'm getting strawberries, milky sort of taste there. These strawberries, I've got to say, yeah, strawberries are really, really hard to get strawberry flavourings. This strawberry is nice. Do you know what it reminds me of, in all honesty? I haven't had one for years, and I know how it tastes because I used to love them. And then, obviously, like being lactose intolerant, like I never was born with it. I sort of like developed lactose intolerance, so I used to drink milkshakes and like ice cream and that shit all the time. It just reminds me of a Yazoo milkshake. It's really sweet strawberry milkshake. It's not artificial. The strawberry packs a punch. It's not hollow like some strawberries can be, really, really hollow. Like this is a really full-on dense flavor of strawberry that's not artificial. Tastes like a strawberry milkshake. It's really good. I get like, I don't get the strawberry on the end though. I get like, I don't know, some sweet taste on the way in, and then I get bang, it just hits you with a strawberry milkshake on the way out. I'm still tasting it now. It really does pack a punch. That's really good. Really good. I'm actually liking that. See, I love, in the summertime, I wish it was summer now, it's freezing, but anyway, in the summertime, I love British strawberries. I don't know what it is, but British strawberries, when they're nice, ripe, freshly picked British strawberries, like, they've got a certain taste to them like no other strawberry across the world has got. I don't care. Like, what anyone says, the British strawberry, when it's freshly picked, like, you can go to these pick-your-own things, go and pick yourself a punnet or a basket of strawberries. Nothing tastes as good as British strawberry, when a fresh, ripe British strawberry that's ready to be picked on a summer's day. I'm telling you now, I love strawberries, and it is very difficult to find that strawberry vape that doesn't taste synthetic, that doesn't taste artificial, that lacks the punch. You know, it's very difficult to find a real decent strawberry. This here, I am actually liking this. This has got a strawberry flavouring down to a T. And I never thought I'd find myself saying that. Okay, albeit it's in a milkshake version. Like, because I'm getting the creaminess of the milk and all that stuff behind it. Like, and that is one thing, being lactose intolerant, that is one thing I do miss. My strawberry milkshakes. Never used to like chocolate ones or vanilla ones. Strawberry milkshake, raspberry ripple ice creams, like the Neapolitan, just the strawberry section. They was the ones for me when I was a kid growing up. Oh, mate. I'm liking it. It's really good. Really dense, full-on flavor. Vapor production again is really good. I'm liking that one. I am really, do you know what, I was liking the first one, but I think I'm liking this one a hell of a lot more. Oh gosh, what's the lemon bonbon going to have in store for us? Because I used to love lemon bonbons too. As you can see, this figure don't come like easy. Anyway, let's take you to the profile of the lemon bonbons. We're going to come back, I'm going to heat it up, and I'm going to tell you guys what I think. So here we go. An electrifying tangy lemon bonbon hard candy infused with a refreshing secret twist. Again, 50ml juice in a 60ml bottle, ready for that short fill. That short fill, ready, nick shot, availability, malarkey, 0 mg nicotine. As with the rest, 70-30 VG-PG. So, yeah. I'm looking forward to this one. There we go. Here we go, let's try this one now. So here we go, I'm back, freshly whipped and whatnot. So here we go. I wonder, that's got a bit of cool lager in it, or is that cold in there, I don't know. But we're about to find out. Here we go, lemon bonbon. In all fairness, yeah, I've just got to say, it's not a hard candy. It is a lemon bonbon, and it's that bit You know, them powdery lemon bonbons that you used to get. You used to get, like, the strawberry bonbons, the lemon bonbons. Nowadays, you can go into the shop and get, like, cola and blueberry and all that malarkey. But back in the day, it was just two, maybe three. It was the yellow one, which was lemon, the pink one, which was strawberry. I know you had the white one, which was like a toffee sort of flavoured one. Anyway, going back to this lemon one. So on the inhale, you get it. You get the sensation like you just popped one in your mouth with that powdery feel. I don't know. It's a very difficult for me to explain it, yeah? But it actually tastes like it. And you know the exhale, it's the bit. You know when you've chewed it, and you've chewed it that much, it's into a soft, gooey mush, and like you've got the flavour there. That is the exhale. The soft, chewy bit. Oh my days. That is amazing. So you're not getting no sharp, like, fresh lemon sort of taste. It's a sweet, and it's that chewy, chewy bonbon bit. You know when you've chewed it, your mouth's all watering and all that malarkey, and you're dribbling down. Well, okay, not that bit, but anyway. Your mouth's all watering, and you've chewed it, and it's really soft, because they're quite hard to begin with, and when you've got your motion going, and then your mouth's all giving it all the watery malarkey, and then it's... That is the bit right there. Oh my god. I feel like I can... Oh. Fucking hell. Let me... Oh, do you know what? Oh, I just want to... I'll drink it. Oh my god. Soon. Yes, that is wicked. I'm loving it. So on the inhale, yeah, I'm sure it's got a little touch of Coolada on the inhale, like, well, not on the inhale, but a little touch of Coolada. I can feel it on the inhale. It tastes a little bit like, I don't know, like a sherbet-y sort of feeling on the way in, like, you know, because it's dusted in whatever fucking coating it's dusted in. They're really dusty things, like they really are. You know what I mean, if you know what they are. You know exactly what I mean. So when you put them in your mouth, that first little bit is like a fizzy sort of like action going on, like sherbet-y type thing. Then they really are giving it all this. And when you get them, like the juices flowing in, it warms up a little bit in your mouth and... You get that taste, bang, this is to a fucking tea. This is spot on. This is a lemon bonbon. Oh my gosh, how? It makes me want to freeze it and start biting chunks off of it. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I am so loving that one right now. Do you know what? Excuse me. Do you know what? As they've got on, they've just got better, like, in taste, in flavour profiling as they've gone on. Seriously, they've just got better. I'm not saying that they're, like, listen, I will tell you straight. If it wasn't no good, you'd know, I'd say it's not for me. There's none of that. I do like the actual flavours, yeah? But I'm not really relating to the white chocolate on this. But that might be my own fault, though, just because I haven't had white chocolate in a hell of a long time. But it's nice, creamy, smooth and silky. That is a really good vape. I do like it. This one, I'm not kind of feeling the cotton candy on it, but the strawberry milkshake side of things, man, bang. It's like, without obviously mentioning names, but it's too late, I've already done it. But Yazoo milkshake, that is nice. That is a nice vape. It's strong, I can smell it through there now. Lemon bonbon, oh my god. This is lovely. This is spot on, exactly what it is. It's just so nice, like, oh, I love it. This is banging. Do you know what I haven't done though with these? I haven't put no nick shots in because I've just opened them here on the review. So maybe if I put nick shots in them, they will change slightly on the profile after a little bit of sleeping or whatnot. But in all honesty, I'm such a lazy twat that I'm not going to put Nick shots in them, just because if I've got stuff with Nick in it, I'll vape it. If they're short fill bottles, I can't be arsed doing this, tipping that in the machine, fucking waiting for fucking. I just want to vape it and go. I'm just a lazy shit. I just can't be asked to do that. But anyway, I'm loving this. So this is the KNDI range from, I think it's an in-house brand from Custom Vapes, which are East London, baby. Plasto, E15. Mate, that is fucking awesome. It's amazing. It really, really is. I am loving that. Do you know, it makes me wonder, just like, as if I'm chewing, like, the toffee bit, like, the toffee, taffy, whatever bit in the middle, like, you know, the chewy gear that you, oh my god, that is awesome. Wow. So, all in all, I've been quite impressed with the flavours. Okay, I wasn't feeling what these two were saying, but I'm feeling the flavours. They're nice flavours. Like, I couldn't quite pick up and, like, you know, on with the chocolatey bit and the cotton candy bit. But apart from that, nice flavours. Good vape. Defo. Would I buy these? Yes. Packaging, one of them was slightly touch and go, I've got to say it, but that's only because I know from when I was a kid what it was. There was a slogan that was on their website that came with that one. I never said it, and I'm not going to say it because I feel me as a reviewer, like, we're getting enough bad publicity and bad press at the moment. In fact, it's not going too good, not too bad right now saying that, so I better touch a bit of wood and, like, you know, don't count chickens and all that shit. But anyway, I wasn't going to say the slogan. You guys can feel free to look on their website and have a look at it, but, you know, I'm not going to say that. So yeah, overall packaging, I'm liking the vibe of the branding. The labeling's really, really good. You know, they got their see-through bits so you can see the juice through. It's not just covered up and you can't see the juice. The juice is clear. You know it's clean juice. Like, you can just see how clean the juice is. Like, especially, like, you know, with ones like the lemon bonbon, for argument's sake, you know, it's like lemon juices can be quite dark, like lemony dark sort of colours. Clear as a bell, literally. They are clear, see-through. Same again with this. Clear as a bell. Only looks pinky because of the pink bit shining through, but it's clear juice. And same with the white chocolate one. Clear. This one's got a little bit of a haze to it, but it's still clear. It's still a clear juice. So that tells me that there's not a lot of crap in there. They're quite clean, as in, like, the ingredients that have gone in there. So yeah, packaging for me, I've got to knock it down a little bit just because of that one was right on the borderline, but I'm liking the vibe that they're going for with the labeling and that. So out of 10, I'd give it probably a 6 out of 10. I would love to have given it a little bit more, but I could see what they was doing with that other packaging, which is not what we're needing right now within the industry. We're not needing it any time. But saying that, I've seen a lot worse out there. So guys, like, I'm not knocking it like that. I'm just, like, basically I'm just saying how it is. Do you know what I mean? Like, you just got away with that one. With my views, by the skin of your teeth. Flavors, spot on, lovely. Okay, the first two, I couldn't quite, like, my brain wouldn't let me grasp that it was a white chocolate, but it was a nice, creamy, velvety vibe going on there. The cotton candy one, I know what cotton candy is. I've been working around it most of my life. I made fucking 300 bags of it for my wedding not so long, well, 2 years ago. So I know what cotton candy tastes like. I wasn't getting the cotton candy vibe from it, but I was getting a nice strawberry milkshake. Like, loving that. That was really good. Lemon bonbon, bang, psh, down the line. Lemon bonbon it was. You could feel the fizzy sherbet on the inhale, like, on the inhale when you inhaled it. Like, when you pop the sweet into your mouth and you got all that powder on it, your saliva just make like, all fizzes up as the powder hits it. That's what it was doing on the inhale. And then after you've chewed it a little while, you've got this like gooey, taffy, toffee type flavoured gear going on inside your gob. That was the exhale. Fucking spot on. I'm loving it. Anyway, so without further ado, I know it's been a long time and I'm going to try and get some more videos up because I need to do it for you guys, I know. But I've been busy, like I said at the beginning. I've just taken over a shop that I'm managing, a vape shop. I have just had like 3 children's birthdays. We have got Christmas just around the corner. You know, I've got a lot of things that I've had going on, but as soon as I can and I get back into it on a regular routine, I will be uploading. I'm still doing the Sunday, obviously, the Sunday super awesome vape show with the guys, you know, so check us out every Sunday. We're with Daily Vape TV, Sir Vaping a lot, Empire Vape Co., Mike's Mex and myself. We have the odd guest. We've got the TVP, the Vaping Postman, if you don't know who he is. He's a guest that comes on quite regularly. We have Vaping with Vic. He comes on a little bit as a guest. We have a few other guys coming on. Shane Wiseman from Bad Boy, Big Boy Coils. He comes on a little bit as a guest as well. So, yeah. Guys, thank you very much for waffling. I know I've rambled on a little bit in the end of this one. But, you know, it was a comeback, like, review. You know, I haven't reviewed in such a long time. I feel that, you know, I needed to just explain a few things. But anyway, without further ado, if you liked it, you know what to do. Hit that like button. You know where the bell is. You got to give that a ring. Ding-a-ling-a-ling. Ring that notification bell. If you haven't done so already, subscribe. Hit the subscribe button. You'll get the notifications and all that if you ring the bell. But for now, vape on, vape safe. I'm Jay. This is LVC Reviews. Live vape and chill, baby. Oh, yeah. Keep it real. Peace out, guys. Thank you very much for tuning in. Vape on and vape safe.